Okay, this is my PC version, and I use KOP for the texture pack on this. We got a couple others, but this one I tend to like a lot. And this is one of my major builds. I just dropped that. Probably gonna be needed. And this is the opening area, the entrance to the world, or what I consider to be the entrance to the world. We have a couple of statues around it, Jax, Nike, and one of her sisters. And also a build I did for a friend of mine on Twitter, Cuppabot. And from the entrance, you can see this is one of the first places I built on this world, and this is what I call Heart Palace. With a couple of gardens along the outside of it. Hedge gardens, I should say. And also, this is a working Go board. You just place the tiles down on this. You use wood blocks or wool blocks for the two different places, but this will work as a Go board. And also a hedge maze. Along with a recorder in the center of it. The play music once you make it to the center. Some parts I do need to put in still, and that is what I'm going to do in this area right here, and I'm thinking maybe another waterfall, and also here, a waterfall garden. And also have an observatory in, as well as a tiered landscape around it. And I still need to put the lens in right here, looking out. I just hadn't figured out a good way to do that just yet. There's gonna be something more within here. But so far, I just have the entrance done, and the entrance is pretty simple. Step on this, and the waterfall eventually comes down. And there's just enough time to get into the doors. And this area is gonna be built up too. It's just I haven't done it just yet. And if you wait right here, the waterfall will eventually go down. Or you could just run right through it. This also includes my first attempt at a walkway, and I just did this by sinking this down to create a light path along the side of the streets with water underneath it. I just thought it looked nice. And this is among my first attempts at parking spots and also roads. And there are other small areas like this right here. These small picnic-like areas. I also have a chessboard along this side over here. And interestingly enough, this is the map from The Shining, or this is the hedge maze from The Shining, using the what you see in the movie for the most part, which is different than the maze that you see in map form in the movie itself. They have a little model of it. And here's a chessboard, along with massive pieces, chess pieces. And more gardens along this side, as well as a yin and yang with water and lava. Going into this, I have pools. I had an art gallery over here, but in one of the updates, all of my art got popped off the wall, and I just hadn't replaced it as of yet. Since I love libraries, I've placed in two libraries, one on both sides. We've been with seating right here. And small nooks, as well as waterfalls. The water would be bad for the books, but I just thought it looked nice. In the future, I'm going to work out a subway between the various builds, and you would get to it through here by going down right here. For the moment, it's just an entrance. And some glass art. The entrance will be right here. For the moment, it's just blocked up. And there are various rooms over here. The whole idea of Heart Palace is basically something dedicated to romance, to love, and all that. So it has two chapels, one on both sides. Like that too, and the chapel on the other side. And this is the other library. This one's a little bit more formal and holds a lot more books than the other one. The other one is more relaxing one. Some place to relax and read. Thank you. and found the themes of romance and love and weddings. There's various suites lining this river walk. And you can see some of them are decorated, such as this one right here. And some aren't. And let's think about doing something else right over here, but I just haven't done it yet. And each of these have basically various walkways and the like along the back. This is going to be, and I need to put in the walls for it, but these are also parts of these apartments. Can't believe I forgot to do that. The end result is, looks like over here. We'll need to put in some of the walls too. But this will allow you to actually look into it. Maybe it had gotten erased with one of the updates. It's been a while since I've been back inside this build. This is one of the decorated ones. Now I'll go down to the first floor. The entrance being right here, kitchen, and the like. Some storage. And what you hear is the fire up above. It's not really operational, but a TV. And more storage. Which leads up to the bedroom area and an open fireplace. And there are multiple balconies. Chairs, reading areas. And also a bedroom right out here in the open. Let me turn down the music just a bit. Let me turn down the music even more. I'm gonna turn it off. And there's small things like this right here. This should be music. And yeah, there's still music. Okay. Across the street from this is a place I call Book Town. And the whole idea behind this is simply apartments shaped like books. Fairly simple behind it. With the reception area being in this book right here with... I couldn't really do tea very well, so I just have water pouring into it. Into this pool area. It's not necessarily meant to be practical, but I thought it looked nice. And there are various apartments in here, with the top two floors being dedicated to suites. as well as gardens on the roof and hot tub. And I'll go into one of the design suites. This one takes up 2 floors. Library office. Storage. It's hard to do a bathroom in Minecraft, but I think I did decently well. A balcony overlooking quite a few areas. And an open concept bedroom area. Fireplace. Many of them aren't decorated, and I hadn't really decorated some of them, and that is mostly because I have this as a download on DeviantArt. So if people want to download it, and they can more easily decorate it however they want. Most of the other ones are similar to this type of build. This type of design. With some basic things in here. Such as couches, the chairs. TV, offices. The other rooms have this type of layout. Bathroom. And bedroom. These small books right here serve as basically walkways and stairs leading up to both sides. About apartments on both sides. And this basically is a rapid way to get down to the first floor. Using this water right here as a sort of break fall. And if you put a sign underneath it, then objects around it, such as glass, the water won't fall. Basically, it'll be suspended right above the sun, and you can use this to make sure that you don't take any damage when you fall from high distances. The only book that's different than these other two different types of books, actually four in a way, is this right here, and that just simply is a drive-through with a tree inside it. Oh, this awkward potion. I meant the potion of night vision. We go. So then. Okay, now you can better see the tree in here. Because of waterfalls. And along the back, there's also a sort of restaurant called the Diary, or this one has more formal seating right here. Such as a restaurant. Kitchens and stuff in here. next to it is more for private parties. The kitchen in here. And each of these are named after parts of a book, such as volume, prologue, chapter, and epilogue. And basically these are just private areas for private parties. And it's basically set up as if someone writing in their journal or their diary to look like that. And there are also other side parks, such as this right over here, which is a open air open door cafe called the Inkwell. Or outdoor grill. And the lid to this ink box forms a cover for it to protect from rain and such. And I tried to do a pin on this side, but I don't think it came out all that well. Or the body of a pin. It kind of looks more like a scroll. I'm still working on the bridge, but here's a yacht I've put in along this riverfront. Entertainment area, office. It's also basically this is the captain's bedroom. So the captain has their own private port, more private deck. And kitchen area. More formal dining over here. Storage and bathroom. And the same over here. And also rooms in here. Smaller rooms, but they are there. And a hold right here for more storage. And some right in here. Basically a cabin in here with the controls for the ship. Oh, Over here is something I did for my dad. It's the US monitor. And I haven't yet extended the order over here just yet, but I will over time as I continue to build. There's also going to be houses in each of these sections. I've already just sectioned it off so I know basically how big they should be. And there's a couple of park areas between these two houses. This is going to be a housing development. And this one also includes a, there's going to be a entrance to the subway right here, but a tunnel lead into what I had always envisioned. I guess you could say this could be a mall area right here, or a restaurant area right here. But it's just a huge space that can be utilized. And some more park areas. And another hedge maze. On both sides of this. Well, this basically being the reward to make a closed off area for privacy. To get to it, you go through the mazes. This was a tunnel that goes underneath the road. It's supposed to look like an arrow. Not exactly sure how that came off, but I think it still looks nice. And this right here is not really all practical, it's just for looks. This is a transition building, I suppose. Suppose I could also put parking underneath it, or have it go down for parking. And some of these are basic houses I've built in this area. Some of them are quite huge. And this is a house. One of the streams that I watch is Watch Girls Play, and this is the house that they use, well, Maddie used on one of their streams for The Sims. It's based on that. Some stuff like this right here wasn't part of it. I just added it in. Such as this pool and this step up area and these fountains right here. But this right here is based on the building Maddie did for, as I said, Watch Girls Play. And I tried to get it as close to it as I could. Still need to fix a few things. That being the roof of one of them. And this is just a chapel I designed to go along with the houses. With an attached office. Well, you can't get to it except by going to the outside, but it's still there. And there's not a lot of parking here, but most of the parking is underneath through here. This doesn't open. And this one is the original house, not really based off anything. It's split into two sides, so this really could be used as a duplex. With a common indoor pool. And deck. Garages, multiple fireplaces. This is based on the house that I saw. Looks like it. I don't think I would have forgotten the windows. And I just like the design of it. So this one borrows a couple of ideas from it. And some of it's original, like this right here. Some areas are more original, so it's not the exact house, but it's fairly close. And this is based off one of the dream homes. One of the dream homes by HGTV. It's kind of hard to do interiors of it. It's much easier to actually concentrate on the exteriors. And this is based on Highclere Castle. The Monk's Garden along it. And I just wanted to do something since I enjoy Downton Abbey, so I decided to try to make something close to the place where Downton Abbey is based on. That being Highclere Castle. And for the most part, I've just done the exterior of it. And there it is. I put in some of the buildings along the back of it as well. There's more buildings than this, but I just stopped at this building. And it also this also includes an archway over here. Not really an archway, but this building. And over here, this is what I did as a commission for a friend of mine. And it is the Royal Masonic School at Rickmansworth Park. It was harder to do sort of curves. So for this one, I just made it squared. I just squared it out. Since doing buildings on an angle is very difficult in Minecraft. So I just made these dorms into a square rather than the sort of semicircle that it is. Reason it's quiet is you really need to be walking on the ground to actually hear it. All the sounds centered on basically the blocks and reflecting off the blocks. So up here, there's no real sound reflecting off anything. That's why it's pretty much silent in certain areas. And as you can see, there's not really any floors in a lot of these areas. Since I just mostly concentrated on the exterior. And I'm going to show another one of my worlds as well. More of a Christmassy build. So there's a clinic right here, along with an ice sort of castle back here. Ice and snow castle. And I need to find another Christmas theme for this particular build. I had one specific one, but it's no longer been updated. But this still gives a pretty good idea of what it looks like. It's also a fire department and police station. This being the police station. And this was just simply supposed to be a sort of like a train setup. And the fire department. And the entrance to the place is meant to be right here. With multiple parks around it. You can see some of the grass here, but originally the Christmas theme I had for it had snow instead of grass. So I'm hoping we'll be able to find another one that I can replace that with. So this is be where you would enter in this world. Lead into this, I guess you could say town hall. And this is based on the town hall at Cambridge, I believe. It's either Cambridge. It's been a while. Along with a massive Christmas tree and Christmas tree skirt. And various small areas like this right here for snowball fights. The two fortresses. And a more peaceful park area. And this is simply the parking area for the town hall. Or also one of the parking areas in general. Along with this private area right here, the only way to get to it is to go through the town hall itself to the upper floors and then walk across this walkway. Several major rooms. And the reason why much as this is set up to be empty is so if somebody wants to download it, they can actually use it and decorate it however they would like. To the parking area. And it really looks nice at night. So that's some of my PC builds. Hope you've enjoyed them. That is it for the moment. Thank you very much for watching.